Welcome back to the channel, Marketing Analytics, where we help you analyze your data so you can make better business decisions. And today we are going to talk about, continue along in our series on Google Analytics, and talk about what you may have seen in some of your reports, which are the source and the medium. We're going to talk about what they may be, some examples, and also how to use them to optimize your website, or if you're specific trying to get sources of traffic to your website, you can at least take a look back and see how some of those results are performing. Now, starting off with source are the actual websites sending traffic to your website. And the mediums are the buckets or categories. So a good way to look at this would be a medium would be cost per click, it would be email, maybe an affiliate, organic traffic, referral traffic, or social traffic. Now the source would be the actual website, like Yahoo could be a source, Google could be a source. Let's say you're doing, if you want to see your medium, which would be social, your sources, if you're doing LinkedIn blogs, it could be LinkedIn. If you're doing some Twitter links, it could be Twitter links linking to your blogs on your website. And so they would show up as your sources of traffic. Now, the best time to want to use these sources and mediums is when you're setting up your campaigns. And if you're using Google URL Builder, then you set up your source, your medium, and your campaign. And then if you want to put in a term or even a creative or do some testing, you can do that with a couple of additional categories. But the reason why this is important is that when you're doing some monitoring your campaigns and you can see these in your all traffic report, you can start to get a feel for how many page views and how many activities. If you're driving revenue, maybe you're doing a series of blog posts and you're sending them out on Twitter and you're getting clicks to the website, but you're not actually getting any sales. So that can help determine either revenue. You can look by total visits. You could look by conversions, goals, what they actually did on your website, engagement, or you can track it by email campaigns. I like to track a lot of my analytics with email campaigns, both for revenue and for visits, and when and where they're actually coming from. So I keep pretty detailed campaign analytics and do it by campaigns with my email, with email being my source, and then the different campaigns that I'm doing, whether it's a nurture campaign, whether it's a call to action campaign, or if I'm doing some specific promotions of some product on some campaigns, I use my source and medium and set those up. And then I'll even do some A/B testing on some different creative, or for different times of the year, I'll do some different specials depending on the website. So you definitely want to take a look at your all traffic report, take a look at your source and medium, see where your traffic is coming from, and then optimize some of those campaigns to try to get more revenue or drive more visits from your different sources and mediums that you're using. Now, the most common ones you're going to see are for, especially for mediums, are cost per click, email, affiliate, and organic. And then for your sources, you're probably going to see Google the most often, but you will see Yahoo. You'll see if you're doing any direct links from partners, you'll see those pop up in your source reports when you're looking at it. And how often do you want to look at your source and medium? Well, again, at a minimum, probably monthly. If you're doing some specific campaigns, you may want to set up some Google alerts to notify you when you hit a certain threshold, or if any of your traffic. Sometimes I like to set up traffic alerts to see if any of my sources or mediums have changed as well. So definitely use your alerts. We haven't done a video on those yet, but that may be one in the future. I'll do a video on how to set up alerts for your source and medium for some of your different kinds of traffic. That is a look at your marketing analytics for today. Remember, if you have any specific Google Analytics videos you want or any other e-commerce definitions, leave a comment below. And remember, share and like this video so that we can get more people tuned in to marketing analytics.